Welcome back to The Morning Mindset. I'm so thankful that you joined me for this opportunity for you and me to get our minds aligned with the truth of God. We're doing it right now through an Advent celebration as we look forward to the Christmas holiday. Before we get started, though, I want to remind you about the things that are going on relating to Not a Needy Person. That is a nonprofit organization that we've created to help receive need requests and then have others come alongside to meet those need requests. It's really a unique sort of a thing. I would love for you to be involved. You can check it out at notaneedyperson.org. You can see the needs that are listed there. And this Christmas season, I know it would be a great blessing to someone in need if you were able to give toward meeting the needs that they have. Please check it out, notaneedyperson.org. All right, today we're going to be talking about three things that are closely connected together: light, fellowship, and cleansing. Let's look at 1 John chapter 1, verses 5 through 7, and we're going to tie this in to our Advent celebration this year. This is John the Apostle, who we think was one of Jesus' closer friends, who is writing to us. And he says, "This is the message we have heard from him and proclaim to you." So stop for a moment and think about that. This is someone close to Jesus saying, "This is what we learned from Jesus and are passing on to you." Okay, I want to pay attention when I hear a statement like that. He says, "God is light, and in him is no darkness at all." Okay, let's pause for a moment. Does that make sense to you? He's using imagery here to show us something about God. God is light, and in him is no darkness at all. Okay, if we use those words light and darkness in their literal senses, we might miss the point. But what he's doing is he's using imagery. When he says God is light, he means God is holy. God is pure. God is everything good that you can imagine. And in him is no darkness at all. So that means no evil, no wrong, no stain of sin that's a part of him. Okay? And then he goes on in verse 6, and he applies the truth about God that he's just told us to our lives. He says, if we say we have fellowship with him while we walk in darkness, we lie and do not practice the truth. So let's stop for a moment, define our terms. Fellowship, what does that mean? Well, it means having harmony with him and being in good relationship with him. So walk through the logic here. If we say, if we're telling others, if we're saying to ourselves, I'm close to God, I have a good relationship with God, I'm tight with God, but we walk in darkness, so sin is in our lives and we're just living that way, we lie and do not practice the truth. So he's saying there's some hypocrisy there, and we've perhaps even fooled ourselves. We're lying to ourselves, making ourselves think we're closer to God than we really are. Then we move on to verse 7. He says, but, okay, here's the contrast. If we walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship with one another, and the blood of Jesus, his son, cleanses us from all sin. So notice a couple of things here that are very interesting. First off, the contrast is if we're walking in the light instead of walking in the darkness. So if we're living lives that are consistently purging sin from our lives, we're trying to align ourselves with God's way of thinking and living. And that's why you listen to The Morning Mindset, right? You're trying to align your mind and therefore your life with God's truth. And he's saying if we walk in the light, then we're being like him. If we walk in the light as he is in the light, you see, we are more in harmony with him. We're showing that the direction of our life is according to his ways. And he says, what comes as a result of that? Well, we have fellowship with one another, and the blood of Jesus, his son, cleanses us from all sin. So that's an interesting thing there. Not that when you walk in the light, there will be no sin in your life. There still may be at times, but you have this confidence that Jesus, his son, is going to cover those sins with his blood because of the kind of faith you're having in him to help you as you live your life day to day. Now, what does all this have to do with Christmas? Well, Jesus is the source of that light in our lives, isn't he? Jesus coming as a child was God's gift of light to us. And all three of the things I mentioned at the beginning of the episode, light and fellowship and cleansing, those come through Jesus. So as we look toward the Christmas season this year, maybe you look at your life and you say, yeah, I am walking in darkness more than in light, and I want that to change. Friends, look toward Christmas with anticipation. Begin cleansing your heart now, confessing your sin, giving yourself to Jesus in a way that He will be fresh and new and alive in your life this Christmas season. Jesus, we thank you for coming as a child. We thank you for giving us the ability to have light and fellowship and cleansing. And we ask you, Lord, to make us new this Christmas season.